Hey everyone, welcome back to another print on demand video. In today's video, I'm going to give you an honest opinion on Placeit versus Kittl. Now, I've been a print on demand seller selling t-shirts online for almost 10 years now, so this review is going to be specific for print on demand t-shirt sellers. With that being said, this video is going to go through everything that actually matters for this business model and the use case of you and me being a print on demand t-shirt seller using these tools. Now, to make this video as helpful as possible, I'm going to be using screen recording in this video. And we're actually going to go through and create a design in each one of these softwares because I have a premium account in both of these softwares. I'll explain why throughout this video and who each one of these tools is better for. So without further ado, if you guys know my style of videos, I like to get straight into it and get into the good stuff. So let's switch over to the computer and get started. Okay, so getting straight into this, I've got Placeit pulled up here and I've got Kittl pulled up here. The first thing that I think we need to talk about in this video is the pricing. Now, in the most simple form here, both of these tools are just about $15 per month. Now, this is strictly a monthly basis. So it's month to month. There's no contracts for either of these tools. The pricing is basically the same. Now, for both of these tools, if you decide that you want to subscribe on an annual basis, you're basically paying for 12 months or a whole year upfront, you do save about $5 per month on both of these tools. So when it comes to pricing for Placeit and Kittl, there's no real difference here. They're basically the same pricing. Now, the next important thing when we are talking about print on demand specifically is the license. So when you are using these tools to create a t-shirt design to sell on print on demand, you need to make sure that you have copyright free and commercially usable fonts, graphics, layouts, everything. When we're talking about both of these tools, they both actually get that check mark. So again, we have a tie here. However, as we start to get into these next categories is where you're going to start to see a difference in these tools. So the next category is the selection of templates. This is one where Placeit is absolutely the clear winner. Placeit has been around for a lot longer than Kittl, so Placeit has a massive head start in professionally made graphic design templates. Not only do they have design templates where you can sort this literally by t-shirt designs, so when you come in here, you can scroll through here and literally there are over 700 pages of t-shirt designs, but also you can go into their logos feature, which not many people actually know that you can do. And then you can go down here, hit show more. And now you have all of these logo templates that you can also use for t-shirt designs. When you go over to Kittl and you look at this, when you are searching through designs, they are still new to this game. So although they are coming out with good design templates, they don't have the backlog or the upload pace of new templates that are getting added to their library like Placeit does. So that is the first big difference between these tools is that Placeit just has a much bigger library. Now, quickly, something else that you should know here is that when you are actually creating a design, so let's go into a t-shirt design and I'm going to pick one that has a graphic here. So this one will probably work for this example. When you scroll over to the side and you click the graphic, the library of actual graphics that you can add in, copyright free, commercially usable graphics that you can put into your designs, again, is going to be a lot larger on Placeit. So not just the overall templates, but the actual graphics that you can use that are fully copyright free and commercially usable, you're simply just going to find so many more of them on Placeit. Okay, and then the last thing that we need to compare before we go into the actual designing process for both of these is the mockups. So both on Placeit and on Kittl, you can create a design and then you can put that on a mockup, similar to what you're seeing right here, a model that is actually wearing the design that you just created. These are great because you can take these mockup photos, you have full rights to use them from both of these different tools, and you can post them on social media so you have plenty of content. You don't have to hire models, but also you can run advertisements if you're using that strategy for print on demand. You don't have to go out and make advertisements. You can basically do it all from within these tools. So how these two tools compare again is going to be one that is very different. So starting with Kittl here, when you create any design from the designer, if you just click up top here, you can go to a mockup. It brings you into kind of their mockup editor here, and then you can search what you want to put that design on. So we want to do t-shirts here, so I'm going to do show all, which is 31 t-shirts. Those are all the mockups that you have to choose from. So again, you're going to be limited here. You're going to see that your options are not as big as if you went over to Placeit. To visually show you what I mean here, if you go over to Placeit, you go to mockups. Let's just click on mockups generally. If you scroll to the bottom here, you can see that there are over 900 pages of mockups. So whatever you are looking for, let's say you want a camping mockup, You just search for that, and you're literally going to have mockups in every niche that you're going into. So if you have a social media page or you need content, this is an entire feed's worth of content that you can have here, and your designs just get added onto hoodies, shirts, mugs, all of that. As if that wasn't enough, here on Placeit, you can actually go to videos, and then you can go over to merch videos, and they have video mockups as well. This is something that is just really crazy to wrap your mind around, but you can do something like this, where it is a video that you can post as an advertisement on social media, and it has the design that you've created on the model, and it actually moves with the model. It looks like they're wearing your shirt. This is something that is super unique to Placeit, and you just have tons of different videos you can choose from. Again, you have over 70 pages of actual video mockups. So Placeit crushes it in the mockups. I really think that there's no comparison from Kittl or really anyone else online. Placeit kind of owns this space. Okay, so that gets us off to a good start of comparing the fundamental things that matter for us as print-on-demand t-shirt designers. Now let's get into the actual designing between these two tools. So let's go from the start. I'll start on Placeit and on Kittl. I'll show you how both of these tools work and where each one of these tools really outperforms the other so that you can decide what's right for you. Okay, so going to the homepage, I'm going to type in camping. Let's make a camping design. Now, once I type in camping here on Placeit, I'm going to scroll down to the left. I'm going to go to t-shirt designs, and these are all camping specific designs. Now, by scrolling through here, you can keep going through, but there are 48 total results for camping as far as t-shirt designs on Placeit. Now, before we choose one of these and edit it, let's go over to Kittl, and I'm going to type in camping. And these are the designs that we have from Kittl for camping. Now, Kittl actually has a really solid selection of camping specific t-shirt designs, and this kind of gives you an idea of the different designs that they have here. So from experience as a print-on-demand seller, when you're looking at the types of templates that are on Kittl and the types of templates that are on Placeit, the biggest difference that I've seen is that over on Placeit, you have very simple design layouts that sell in print-on-demand. They're not overly complex. They are proven design styles that sell well for the print-on-demand business. When you come over to Kittl, the biggest thing that I've noticed from using this is that their designs are very intricate. The bulk of them have a lot of elements added into them, which is not necessarily a bad thing, but it takes more time to customize and create that design to make it ready to upload to a print-on-demand website. Now, as we keep going through this, I will show you what I mean here, but I'm going to pick one of these and we will customize them side by side. This is a good design right here. I'll show you what I mean as we're designing this. So I'm going to open that over here and I'll pick one over here as well. This is a really solid camping template that's minimal and I know sells well. So I'm going to use this as a perfect example. Ultimately, when it comes down to it in print on demand, you want to try to create as many good designs as you can in the shortest amount of time. You don't want to skimp on the quality of your designs, but you also don't want to get hung up spending an hour or 2 hours on a single design. So this is where I've noticed the biggest difference between the tools. If I come in here and I type in camp more, worry less, and then I just come through here and I add in a graphic, I'm going to type in camping, and I choose one of these graphics. The graphic instantly gets subbed out. It gets subbed in with this one. The text is already wrapped in the right place. I can simply click the color. I can switch this to match it. And then I can just click background color, remove this to transparent. And I can literally click download right now. And I have a fully custom design ready for a print-on-demand t-shirt. Now, I've used this template a lot before, so I know how quickly I can click around here. But that gives you an idea of how quickly you can create a design on Placeit just because they have optimized things here. They've made it so when you type in your text, it already fits. You don't have to realign or resize anything. When you start clicking on graphics, they already fit into the template and they replace the one that was existing right here. So you don't have to go and delete the original one and resize the new one to go in its place. When you come over to Kittl, this is where you're going to see that these tools are very different. So if I start to customize this and I type this in camp, I'm going to actually do fish more. Now I click off of that. Well, I have to edit the text that's in the back as well. Fish more, and now that has the right shadow, and then I can do worry less. And now I have to figure out what to do with this text that's at the top. If I just delete it, it may not look just right. And then I've got text over on the left and on the right. I have to make sure that the text makes sense in this design and it's not confusing people when they initially see this design with just too much information. So they kind of run into paralysis by analysis and then they just keep scrolling past your design and they don't buy it. And then the big thing that I've noticed using Kittl is that this graphic over here, when you come over to the left side and you go to add in another graphic, you can type in fishing. Although they have good graphics that you can use and you can even pull this out so you can see them all at once. It's a lot easier to see all of this. When you click on one of these graphics and you go back to your canvas, it just adds the graphic on top of this graphic. So now I have to delete this graphic. I need to put this one back in the middle and you can align it center here just to make sure that it fits. It's a little bit high, so I have to bring it down custom. And then I know that I need to change the colors of this so that this fish matches the rest of this. So I can literally go in here and I can change the colors, try to customize this to fit the design better. That's a closer look, so I'll go with that. Or I could come down to the bottom and I can click on the color palette and I can switch the whole palette of this design. If you are going to do this way, a quick tip is just turn auto adjust brightness, turn that off and it'll make your colors more true here. So you can see that this is starting to come together. This might actually work, but you can already see how much time we have invested in this design just to find something that's going to look good. Compared to what we did on Placeit, our design was already downloaded and we could be moving on to our next design already. However, with that being said, you can create really good designs here. And when you go to download them, you can just take the background out. You can optimize the quality so you have a high quality design and then you can download it. So you can take the background out just like you can on Placeit. You can do all of the things that you can on Placeit. I would just say though that the design templates that are on Kittl are much more intricate. They're probably more for advanced print-on-demand sellers who are willing to spend more time creating their designs, as opposed to over on Placeit, you can create just really solid designs just in a couple clicks. They've kind of optimized this for speed. So someone who uses the print-on-demand strategy that I do, where you're just trying to find good niches that don't have many other sellers in them and create a bunch of really good designs and get them uploaded to the big print-on-demand websites, this tool is by far a lot more efficient and it takes less time to create each design. If you are a beginner in print on demand, or if you're someone who's just trying to create a lot of good designs quickly and time efficiently, Placeit's going to be the tool for you. If you're someone who is going into the big competitive niches in print on demand, or you have to go into a certain topic where you know people already have good designs, Kittl is going to give you more advanced templates. Also, I should say here, if you have your own clothing company, like if you're using Shopify, Printify, Printful, and you can spend the time to create one-off t-shirt designs that you're going to have in your store, and you're not going to have a ton of different designs, you just want really good designs for your brand. Again, Kittl is going to be the one that gives you those really intricate, really detailed templates. Again, I have access to both of these tools. I will put a link in the description to both of these tools if you want to check them out. I have a discount code for Placeit. I don't have one for Kittl to offer you guys, but the link down below for Placeit will give you 15% off of any of their plans, making it a little bit cheaper per month than Kittl. With all that being said, as always, if you guys have any questions or specific things between these tools that were not in this video and you're curious about, just let me know down in the comments. I'd be happy to help you out. Otherwise, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and I will see you guys all in the next video.